The Iron Hands are famed for their armoured warfare and their ability to lead from the front, a trait that ultimately saw their undoing at the Drop Site Massacre. Hello and welcome to this Horus Heresy painting video. In this video, we're going to show you to paint a legionnaire in the colours of the Iron Hands. However, by following the methods and techniques in this guide, you can easily apply it to other models in your collection. So when you're ready, grab those brushes, shape those paints, let's get started. Now, before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. As you can see here, we've used lead belt, which is a perfect starting point for our Iron Hands colour scheme. So the first colour we're going to be using is Corvus Black, and this is going to be for some black details, such as the armour, as well as the gun casing. So first of all, what I'm going to do is just load some of that up onto my palette. So I get a couple of dollops there, a little bit of water, just so it's not too thick and goopy. And then all I'm going to do is just roll my brush so it gets to a decent point, and then we're ready to start base coating. So like I said, we've got things like the armor panels, we've got the gun casing, and don't forget those joins between the armor as well. And you might just want to apply a couple of coats of this. With those black details now picked out, what we're now going to do is move on to applying a contrast. And for this, we'll be using Basilicon Grey. Now I'm going to apply this all over those black details, as well as the silver areas as well. So what I'm going to do is just load up my brush. I'm just using it straight from the pot. Just so I don't overload it too much, I'm just going to get to a decent point. And then, like I said, this is going over everything. So just take your time, work your way around. In some places, you might need to add a second coat. Also, sometimes when using metallic undercoats, sometimes it does spread around a little bit. So you just need to work on that area a couple of times and eventually it'll just settle in. With the Basilicon Grey now fully dry, what we're now going to do is move on to picking out some details on the armour. First of all, we're going to get Iron Hand Steel. I'm going to dry brush this just to add a little bit more punch to those edges. And also, we'll get a small layer brush and just add some extra little bits of chip in there after that. And then finishing off, we're going to get some agate sachet just to run into those recesses to make it look a little bit oily and old. But first of all, let's start with our dry brush. So what I'm going to do is just get a little bit of Iron Hand Steel on my dry brush. Just going to do some circular motions, crisscross motions. And as all we're trying to do here is remove as much of that pigment from those bristles as possible. So once I've done that, I'm quite happy. So then we're just going to start gently dry brushing that over the raised areas. Now I'm going to get this on the black as well as the silver, because I want that black to look a little bit more metallic and old. So just take your time, work your way gently around the model, not put too much pressure. What you're aiming really to do is almost like tickle the model. That dry brushing now done, all I'm now going to do is just get a small layer brush and just add some extra little punch to those bits of chips. So again, just where you got some of those lines from the dry brushing and just bringing out some of that silver on things like the working parts, such as on the gun, etc. Now that we've added some extra chip in using a small layer brush, what we're now going to do is get some agate shade and just drop this into some of those deeper recesses, just to make the Iron Hands feel a little bit more oily and battle-worn. There we are with the Agrate Earthshade now dry. You can see it's just added a little bit of grime into those recesses. So what we're now going to do is move on to those final colours. First of all, I'm going to use Grey Sear. This is to pick out the eye lenses in preparation for that contrast, and also just to mark a line down on his helmet, just to break up what is quite a dark and grim looking figure. And after that, we'll get Talisar Blue to pick out those eye lenses. But first of all, let's start with that Grey Sear. So I'm going to thin this down a little bit. So I'm just going to pop a little bit onto the palette, a little bit of water, like so. Get my brush to a nice point. And I'll start first with those eye lenses. So what I'm going to do is just carefully whip my way in. And if you do make any mistakes, you can always just get a little bit of Iron Hand Steel, and Basilicon and Grey as well. And for the line down the helmet, what I'm going to do here is just take my time, start with a line that just goes down the top. I'm not going to put it onto the actual beak of the helmet. I'm just going to keep it on the top like so. And I'm just going to broaden it out a little bit. And I might do a second coat of that. With the eye lenses picked out and that marking done, what we're now going to do is just get some Talisar Blue and drop that into the lenses. With those lenses now picked out, our Iron Hands is pretty much finished. All that's left to do now is to base the model. Now we're going to start first by applying some Armageddon Dunes all over. Once that's dry, we're going to get some Basilicon Grey and apply that over the top of that just to make it nice and dirty. And then we'll finish off with a dry brush of Screaming Skull. But first of all, let's start with our texture paint. So what I'm going to do is get the large scoop side first. I'm just going to plonk some of this onto the actual base, like so. and then just start using the smaller side just for a bit more accuracy. Take your time, and you want to leave this to dry for around about an hour. So all I'm going to do now is just apply basilicon and grate all over. It's going to make that sand look nice and dark and dingy, but as it dries, you'll start to see some of that Armageddon dune showing through. That basilicon and grey now dry, what we're now going to do is start dry brushing up that texture. I'm also just going to do it around the greaves and the feet as well, just to tighten nicely with the base. There we are with those details on the base now done. All that's left to do is paint the rim in a colour that matches your army. For this one, we've used Steel Legion Drab. With our model and base finished, our Iron Hands Legionnaire is ready to join his brothers and bring swift retribution to the Emperor's foes. Now, there's a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when doing any dry brushing, try and remove as much of that pigment from the bristles as possible. Remember, when highlighting, just do a couple of layers of that. Also, when using shades and contrast, try not to overload your brush as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, just dry off your brush and use it to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own Iron Hands, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.